Fusion IP is a company that works with Sheffield and Cardiff universities to market business opportunities that come out of academic research from those revered institutions. We're talking now to the chief executive, David Baynes. David, welcome.
Thanks, Jim.
I want to start first of all by talking about the numbers that have only really recently come out, which showed pre-tax profit 1 million after a 1.6 million loss this time last year. So congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Profit excluding spin-out costs and amortization, 68%, I think, is a big turnaround there.
Yeah.
And revenue's up 35% year on year. Clearly, the results are improving, and improving year on year.
Indeed.
What knobs are you turning to get this sort of result?
I think it's slightly in the nature of what we do. You remember, we're about commercialising very early companies, very early ideas that were being spun out of universities. And in the first years, when you first start, where we were started spinning companies out in sort of 2005, they're very small, and they take a while to grow. Now we're beginning to get to a number of companies that are getting that kind of critical mass, becoming quite decent sized companies. There's about 230 people now working in our group companies. And so of course now you begin to see material improvement year on year in the underlying portfolio. And that's then reflected in the numbers.
When we spoke to you back in December on Proactive Investors, you were saying then, you were talking about 8 to 10 companies that are worth watching. How has the year developed with your portfolio?
I think that remains about the same. We actually have a total of about 24, mm-hmm. but they tend, obviously they're not all going to work, and that we're in a very high risk part of the game. From when you very, very first start companies, we expect probably about one third of those will ultimately be successful, and a third okay, and a third probably not work at all. So we've still got about 10, 11, 12, which we consider to be strong.
And what about the number of spin-offs a year you anticipate? Again, going back to your interview we did with you back in December last year, there was a very ambitious target of something like 3 a year, but clearly that hasn't happened this year.
Well, we only did one this year,
right?
But we've got 3 on the books for the next year. So it remains kind of right-ish, maybe more like about 2 a year. The thing is, there's no point setting up companies unless they're any good. You know, you can get a headline figure of having created companies, but actually every time you create a company, if it's not a good one, you're creating years of hardship, funding and effort. So you want to make sure you really only start them if you think there's a good chance you can make them work.
How much of that, though, is the company itself, and how much of it is the market conditions that is dictating whether or not you spin them off?
Now, fun enough, it really has been the pipeline. We haven't not been doing activity because we thought we didn't have the funds to do it. We've actually not done it because we didn't think in the last year there was anything more than one that really justified it. But as I say, we're quite confident the sort of pipeline we got at the moment, and there are about 3 at the moment, which I think over the next 12 months we'll actually be starting up.
Now, there's a difference, isn't there, between the spin-off and exiting, isn't there, a company?
Yep.
When are you going to start exiting? Because presumably that's when the real money starts to come back through to
that's
to
right. Investors. They're almost the opposite extremes, aren't they? Spinning out is the start, when you very first start an idea at a university. Exiting is when you finally sell it. That has been the bit that's taken longer than anyone expected. I think when people like us started these kind of models, we talked, perhaps rather optimistically, about 3 to 4 years until we get exits from starting companies. Not really realistic, I think. The 6, 7, 8 years is more realistic from a beginning to an exit. And that means we're now beginning to move into that phase for some of our companies. We do believe we'll probably get some kind of decent exit in the current year, certainly.
Going back to the numbers you just released, you're sitting, I think, on some £2 million cash. You anticipate it'll generate additional funds during the year, either through trade sale exits or dividends. However, I know that it says in your numbers that, or the statements, the directors continue to review all financing options. What are those options?
Well, we absolutely do. And that's because when you're relying upon selling a company as your revenue, which is effectively what our model is, you know in the longer term you're definitely going to do it. You've got these good companies, they're worth something. It's actually very difficult to predict month on month, even quarter to quarter, whether something really will exit. You can be negotiating a deal, as I'm sure you're aware, and then it doesn't happen. So to just say, oh, it's okay, we'll wait till we get exits for funding, perhaps isn't the most prudent approach. And clearly, depending on circumstance, if we believe that they're not going to come quickly enough, we will consider fundraisings. And that's the obvious approach. We're AIM listed and we have access to markets for that reason. You can never guarantee that as a route, but actually we're relatively confident we have a very supportive shareholder base, and we do believe we're doing the right things to demonstrate we're getting value out of this portfolio.
One of the other lists, when you're looking at revenue, your income, one of the other items on there is through license income. Yeah. And I think this is predominantly through Sheffield, isn't
it? It is, yeah.
How much of a part of Fusion is licensing income? And do you see that changing over time?
Yeah, at the moment it's quite small. Not the year just reported, but the year before was relatively good. We generated about 500,000, 600,000. But in the current year, it's been a much smaller number, about £60,000. It sounds disappointing, that, but actually it's slightly in the nature of licensing. You start up a number of these licenses. Often they really only start paying decent income when the product they relate to comes to market, and that in turn starts growing in terms of sales volume. And we do have a couple of licenses, one we hope to sign fairly shortly, which I think have good long-term prospects. So there'll be a percentage of an ultimate product, which will be a relatively big number. But it will take time, and licensing won't generate significant short-term increases.
If you look down the list of companies you've got, I mean, you mentioned that you had some really big ones, relatively speaking, within the group. Mm. Give us some update, if you can, on some of these, like SimSip, Magnomatics, and Phase Focus. Yep. I think investors will want to know more about.
Good choice of companies. SimSip's a very good business. It's got about 60 staff. It's growing very fast. I think it recently won an award as a 16th fastest growing company in the UK. Right. Profits are up again, about from 1.7 to 2.3 million before tax. Turnover's come up from 4.8 to just under 6 million. And that kind of rate of growth looks like it's going to continue.
What does this do, this company?
What they do is they have software which can be used at the very early stages of clinical trials. And effectively, you can use software rather than, for example, animals. It's a very good company, really, from that aspect. And it will allow you to run simulations. If you've got a new chemical entity, a new drug, and you want to know how that might work, how that might interact, for example, with drugs already on the market, you can run a simulation in software using this model, these models, and it'll give you very accurate indications of how that drug is likely to interact, actually, if it was given to human beings.
How about Magnomatics? What's that doing? How's
completely
that
different extreme, right. Doing very well again. Revenues have gone 300,000 the first year, an annualised 800,000. It'll do about 1.6 million this year, so up about 100%. That's going to have 20 staff by the end of the year, and that is an engineering. So that's got magnetic gearboxes. So people will be familiar with the cogs on a bicycle. We've got an engaging gear. Well, what ours uses is concentric magnetic bands, which don't actually engage. They use that power of magnetism, whereby you can attract one cog to the other, and you can generate a geared effect. So one turns once, never turns eight times, for example. It's lighter. It doesn't need lubrication. Mm-hmm. For example, if it was in a wind turbine, if a wind blew, rather than shearing your gears, they'll just run free. And then when they slow down again, they'll re-engage. So it's quite superior to traditional gearboxes.
And Phase Focus?
Phase Focus offered another angle. And earlier in turnover, just raised a decent sum of money this year. Technology's really good. We'll probably only turn over about 650 this year, its first proper year of revenues. But that has technology for microscopes. So this is microscopes that don't use lenses. Which you would think, well, why would you want that? Well, it has a lot of benefits. For one, it's the lens, the quality of the lens that limits the quality of that magnification you can get. It works in normal optical microscopes that you might have used at school, but it uses in the whole electromagnetic scale, so X-ray microscopes and electron microscopes it works in. And I find you, particularly in the latter, the technology looks, overused word coming up, but very disruptive. Right. So actually something that genuinely seems to achieve results that you were previously limited by the technology. So we're getting some quite remarkable light electron microscopes using this technique.
One final question. I mean, you, as I said at the top of the interview, you work very closely with Cardiff and Sheffield. What about other universities? Have you got any others in your sight?
That remains absolutely the plan. We think we're doing a really good job for our universities. Our universities are great partners. We have a very good relationship with both of them. We've always wanted to add a third Russell Group university. Russell Group are the top 20 research intensive universities. Both Sheffield and Cardiff have about 100 million a year research spend. They're top quality institutions. We hope to add one more into that bracket. We've always felt that three universities would give you a more reliable pipeline, if you like, of companies, new companies, and then probably you will definitely be getting two to three a year. We have an interested party. It's all about funding. In the current market, it's quite difficult to fund, but we'll still work at it, and hopefully in time we will end up being a free university.
Okay, all right. Very interesting. David, thanks for joining us after those results there. David Baynes, Chief Executive Officer of Fusion IP.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorised by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.